Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the sample series, and today we're going to start on chops and stretching a sample. So chopping a sample is the most common method, and I'll show you a couple ways in FL to chop a sample. So the first one is Fruity Slicer. I rarely use this. The second one is, Slice X is going to be your next one. And the third one is going to be the actual playlist, which I actually have begun to prefer. I used to never put anything in the playlist, but over time I found out a couple shortcuts that let me love the playlist. So let's grab a sample to get rocking. Now, when you're doing the chop method, the reason I choose chop method sometimes is just see what its sample sounds like chopped up. Like, instead of wasting time stretching and doing all this stuff just to find out you don't like it, the reason I do the chop method is because I just want to chop it up real quick. So let's grab a sample from tracklib.com. We're looking for something with a lot of different impacts per bar or beat so that there's a lot of different changes along the way. So if you're in FL, if you want to preview the entire song, you click it once and then hit Alt, left click it again, and then you'll be able to listen to it all the way through. That one's pretty instrument heavy. Let's do this one because it's chord based. Okay, so what we're going to do is grab Slice X, for example, just drag it inside of Slice X. You can even do this inside of Edison. So you don't need Slice X to do this specific function. But if you're trying to play it over the keyboard, I use Slice X. So go to Regions tab, go to Auto Slice, and start with Medium Slicing. So what this does is it automatically figures out all the different transients of the song. Okay, so the point of this, again, is just to kind of get a gist of what it would sound like. So now you just go through and you play the keys. So if you wanted to create a rhythm, let's go to Snap to Grid. I need it. See how, like, it's kind of vague and it's all these little tiny chops. So sometimes it's not the best method because it's very hard to get a musical phrase going. Sometimes it chops it up too much. So let's go to Auto Slice Dull Slicing. Now, there's really no middle ground between medium and dull. Dull is just almost like huge chunks, whereas medium is... Okay, so let's do that. So let's just do basic stuff. Another thing is we didn't even map out the BPM, so the BPM does not match. So when you're making these chops, it was hard to have the rhythm at the 140 mark. So all I'm saying is slicing helps you just get a general gist of what it could sound like. So let's create a rhythm out of what we've heard so far. Let's go to Snap to Grid 1/4 beat. And with Slice X, when you drag the sample out, it plays the sample all the way through. If you cut it short, it will cut the sample short. Okay, so I'm just roughly, this is why I said it's a rough kind of way to do it. We need like a two. A lot of claps in this. And what you could do, the cool thing about slicing this way is you could hit shift down or shift up to get different rhythms and different cuts. That just sounds pretty cool. Okay, so let's keep that, even though, you know, it's not the exact thing we want. Now, the next thing about Slice X specifically is that you can affect everything all at once with what are called articulators. So articulators help you do a lot of things to the entire group of sounds. So by default, everything is routed to articulator one. So you see these numbers, articulator one, 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 one. It's saying that every sample is mapped to articulator group one. So this is just where stuff's routed. This section is what the routing is doing. And then this section is like the shape of whatever's happening. So for example, if we wanted to add a filter to the entire sample, we would affect articulator one, turn it on low pass filter times one, turn the resonance down, and now let's. And now it's affecting all those samples because they're all automatically grouped to group one. We can even affect the pitch as a whole. Let's pull it up 300 cents. Now, the thing about pitching it up this way is that it speeds it up. Okay, so that's the one thing about using this is that it's not time stretching this stuff. Now you can have that unique little texture to it. See here, it says speed here. But that's only for marker number one. Okay, so now that we know how that works, let's talk about time stretching. So again, that's one way to chop it and do it. Now, if you wanted to do it in the actual playlist, here's how I would chop it. Now, I do everything visually first, or like audibly first, before I worry about the metronome. And that's because the metronome does not sync automatically to the sample. So we need to chop musically first, then stretch it to the tempo. So let's figure out where we want to chop. Grab this little slice tool. Far cry from a 30. Far cry. No bend. And abuse is just a. So let's just to be like easy about it, we're not going to make too many chops. So you have to listen to the music. You have to know what a downbeat is. For example, a downbeat is when you begin measuring the music. So it's one, two, three, four, two, two, three, four, three, two, three, four, four, two, three, four. Okay, so that's what the downbeat is, that loud beginning portion when we start to measure. So we just have to listen to the music and ask, okay, where's the downbeat? So you can start to hear where the beats are. So grab the slice tool, hit Shift Alt, and then left click to do a vertical slice where you can move it around. So Shift Alt, left click in FL Studio. And then you want to focus on this little transient or the pointy part of the audio. That's a giveaway as to where it starts, is this little pointy part right there. So it's one, two, three, four, two, two, three, four, and one, okay? So if you have trouble counting, count it like one and two and three and four and, because some samples are not as easy to visually see where stuff begins and ends. You might have a sample that has no drums and the music is just different. So sampling, you just got to know how to count music, really. One, two, three, four, two, two, three, four. Now I chop usually in 2-bar increments. I don't chop at 4 bars because older music is played it's not so quantized. And that means 4 bars is 4 bars, but you know, if you were to turn on a metronome, it could be faster than the metronome or it could be slower. And so that's why I only chop for 2 bars. So let's count the next chop. One, two, three, four, two, two, three, four, and. So what you have to keep in mind when you're chopping is, just like in music theory, you have to have resolve. Your sample needs to have resolve too. So a lot of people, they'll chop a sample and the brain's like, okay, it needs to end, like the melody needs to end, and they forget to chop out the melody ending in the sample. So it just sounds like an infinite loop and it doesn't satisfy the listener because the melody never resolves. So when you're chopping, you need, like, I'll say part A and a part B. That's not always the case, but for the most part, you want to have at least a part A and a part B, okay? So the rest we're just going to get rid of. So grab this sample that you just took out, hit Control to highlight, left click, and just drag it all the way to the left. Now the second thing we need to do is time stretch. This is why I like Ableton, because Ableton does all this work basically for us. But FL, you got to do a little work. So the first thing we're going to do is you have to decide, is this your final chop? And that's, I say that because, never mind. Let's just teach you one way and I'll teach you a different way. So let's make this unique, because we want this one to be different than this one. If I time stretch this one, I want it to be different than this one time stretch. And that's okay. So just leave it at that. So go to the audio clips right here and then click on stretch mode. And what we're going to do now is line it up to the left side. So it's perfectly lined up. Change your snap degree to a bar mode, so it's easier to count. And we chop 2 bars. So we need to stretch this. It's not all the way 2 bars. So we need to make it 2 bars. So hit Alt with your mouse and just left click. As long as you have time stretch mode on, you'll be able to stretch the sample to fit. And if you don't see that, you could hit Shift M to turn it on and off, this button here. But go to the audio clips, it should be right there. So now when I hit play, it lines up to 2 bars exactly, but the problem is it changed the pitch, which sounds cool, but it changed the pitch. So if you go to the top left, go to channel settings, we're gonna go to mode, put it on stretch mode. And what this does is it doesn't change the pitch. Now, if you want it to change the pitch, you can do it with actual measurement. So you can now go to the pitch icon and pull this down, let's say 200 cents. And now you know it's exactly 2 notes below the actual sample. And that gives you a lot of musical clarity to do it that way. Let's grab the second sample, hit Alt, left click. The first thing we need to do is line it up with this column. So let's hit Alt, left click, and just make sure it lines up. You just zoom in with your mouse there. And then we want to grab that right side. So hit Alt, left click, drag. Okay, so now it's perfectly within 2 bars. Again, go to the top left, go to channel settings, go to stretch mode. I would recommend you make this unique. It's going to give you a message that says it's already unique, but just hit yes. Okay, and now we can treat these independent of each other. Okay, so now we're going to pull this one. So the first one was pitched down 200 cents. The second one wasn't. And that's the cool stuff you can do when you make it unique. Now, I'm trying to think of a scenario where you would. So wait, let me think in my brain for a quick second. So for example, there's another mode called Make Unique as Sample. And we do this when we want to do things like reverse. So for example, if I click in the top left, go to channel settings, and I hit reverse, it reverses the entire song. So it doesn't just reverse just this clip, it reverses the entire song. So that's why sometimes you want to make it unique as a sample. So let me just show you what I'm talking about. It won't reverse just what we heard. We didn't even have vocals in the original. So you're like, where'd those vocals come from? It's because it reverses the entire thing. So when you're making something unique, it doesn't only listen to just that section. So if you wanted to reverse this, for example, you would have to make it unique as its own sample. And what FL does is it takes basically a screenshot of just this part and it makes it a sample. So let's do that and just save it. So now when I go to the top left, go to channel settings and hit reverse, it reverses only that section. Did we have vocals? Now I'm like, wait, I guess we did have vocals, okay. But that's the actual section. Whereas if you did it before and hit reverse, it just flips the entire song. And wherever it lands, that's where it places it. So that way you can, like let's say you have something you want to reverse only for one section, you could do that. Make it unique as sample, very important. And then it will be able to be reversed. So that's a case where you would have to make it unique as a sample. Now the reason I didn't make it unique as a sample the first time is because sometimes, I'll show you a different trick right after this, which is sometimes you could chop it and replace sections. So let's hit play. So let's say you want to create like a little remix vibe. Let's go to Snap to Grid. We're going to switch it to like a beat or a half beat. And I'm going to use the second one because the first one we already made unique as a sample. So if I take off stretch mode, very important to take off stretch mode under the audio clips tab, take off stretch mode, or hit Shift M to turn it on and off. That's good. Okay, Shift M. Notice how if I left click and drag it, there's no more music on the left or the right side. That's because when you save unique as a sample, it just looks only at that audio and saves it only as that audio. Whereas if you make it unique, it still has the song that you can slide around. Okay, so what this allows you to do, for example, is grab the slice tool. It's like chop out that small little part, for example, with the slice tool. And my other favorite tool here is the slip tool. So I usually change my snap trigger to a beat mode and then left click and drag the audio around, and it lets you replace the audio. So as you listen. So it just adds whatever the audio is on. So that way you don't have to create chops in the piano roll. You do it right in the playlist. So let's make some more obvious chops here. And again, you could chop it all the way down to the fourth beat if you wanted to, or lower. Grab that slip tool. I'm just going to keep it on the beat mode. And I'm going to, let's move this around so you can see what's going on. So I chopped that to change, and I chopped this. And we're going to change those two with the slip tool. So you just got to find a section that sounds good. Those sounds were not meant to be there, but it sounds seamless because of all the stuff that we did. Okay, so that way you can make a little DJ chops instead of it just being a straight playthrough. Same chopped feel without doing a bunch of stuff in the plugin. And the cooler part about doing it this way is that you can visually see what's happening. You could reverse stuff. So if you wanted just to make that a reverse section, you could save it as a unique sample and click in the top left and hit reverse. You could do cool stuff like this, which you can't do in the auto slice stuff. Okay, so you get the concept, and you could be more creative with that. But I wanted to show you, you know, how to time stretch and how to chop in this video. Next, we're going to focus on phrase sampling, which is strategic sampling. So let's move into part two. Thank you. It's Game from BusyWorksBeats.com.